My name is Stevan Subić and I'm the comic artist from Serbia. Well, the idea was when I started to work on it, I wasn't aware what is it about. So I firstly was contacted by DC in late January of 2022. At the moment I didn't know what is it about. So everything happened in 10 days. And they, after they approached me, I was signing the NDAs. And then at one moment, maybe 1 week later, they asked me about some things, maybe additional work or something like that. And the reason why I haven't got the contract signed at the moment, after all of those talkings with the editors, was the detail that I need to see Paul in person, because we need to meet. And that is the moment when I figure out what is it really about. It is the Batman, it is the film, it is the actor, and it is the Paul. And in that moment, when you are seeing what DC is expecting from you, you are not choosing anything really. It chose you. So, answer to your question is that I haven't got a chance to choose. But in a way, if I will have a chance to choose, I will choose the same. So, I'm a huge fan of Batman. The Riddler was the perfect character for us to do together. So, that was the beginning. Well, Paul talked with his movie maker, his redactor, it is the Matt Reeves, so it is happening between them. They decided to do this kind of story, and Matt Reeves suggested to Paul that it should be done in a form of comic, because Paul is preparing for his role really deeply. It was already, almost everything was on its place, and Paul decided to do a comic right after, while they were still shooting the film. But then they looked for the artist for some time, DC and Paul, and then they haven't found adequate person for that, like you know, somebody who can do it properly, in a way to satisfy Paul's and everybody else's expectations. So when I came into the story, the story was already written, prepared, and the only thing that was missing is the artist, and that was the part that I was filling in, hopefully good enough. Mm-hmm. First time when we met, that was by the Zoom, and that was I guess somewhere in February of 2022. And then after that, in the coming months, like 4 or 5 months, we were talking maybe on every 2 days for 3 hours by Zoom, mostly about the comic, about the stories, about the details, evolution, arcs of the character, and Gotham and the costumes, and you know, everything else. But we haven't met until the New York last year, so maybe after a year and a half of intense communication and jamming about the project and series, we finally met each other a few hours before the famous DC panel of Gotham, where we were unannounced guests. We were super secret guests, I mean Paul and I, and that was the moment where we met for the first time in person, and we had two amazing days together there. Basically, it is all the same. I mean, the only difference is that there is a screen or without screen. So it is the same person, it is the same communication, same energy. So, no, I'm not doing anything related to Matt Reeves' Pantheon and stuff at the moment. As far as I know, they are preparing second or the sequel of the film. And in the way of the comics, nothing is happening in regards towards the Matt Reeves' ideas in film, as far as I know. So my part was the Riddler, and I was deeply enjoying it. I think that I gave everything that I got in those 6 chapters that we are signing now here in Angoulême. And that is as far as I'm concerned. So after that, I already finished 2 episodes of Penguin with Tom King, which is the supervillain, same as the Riddler. And the first episode of those two is already published a few days ago in the States. And the second one is going to be published in February. So for now, that is it. I already signed a contract with DC for the new stuff, but I cannot share what is it about. But I'm staying with DC, and I guess that you're going to like it. If you like the Riddler and maybe hopefully Penguin, you're going to like this one as well. Well, I'm the European artist, and I'm taking with me the heritage of the European schools, French one, Italian one, and one from the Serbia. I produced 5 books in France, one of those is Conan, and I produced 4 books in Italy. The Riddler is somewhere in between, because I'm not a superhero classic artist, you know. I was trying to make the compromise between the approaches, like I'm not going to do traditional superhero American comic, because it is not something that we want, Paul or I, but I also don't want to do traditional European comic, because Bande dessinée is not something that can be easily given to the readers in the States and to be accepted. So I wanted to make a compromise as a European artist to mix those approaches, so superhero comic and the European one. And the most influential one that helped me to decide which approach I will use is the one from Italy, one that most likely you haven't heard for. It is the Le Storie episode of 65. I produced that comic 5 years ago, and it is really similar to the drawings of the Riddler, but not the character, but the atmosphere, the backgrounds, you know, in that kind of the graphic way. And the idea was coming from there. And also there is one also very interesting detail in way how I draw it. For example, in those 4 or 5 months of beginning when we talked about the story, I offered a few ideas to Paul how we can do some things, like to make the arc of the evolution of the character, which can be also not only the other, the city itself, and you know, all of the other stuff. And one of those ideas were the covers, to do the joint covers pieces, and at the end, final one, which is now the cover of the limited edition here in France. So those are the joint covers of the Bimonti episodes as they're going. It is really tough to be produced, because Alex Ross was the guy who produced that before me, but when they're doing it, they are doing it like this. They are joining covers in a row, like connecting that way, because it is really easy, you need to know just one. And maybe the part of the second one, third one is totally unimportant because they're joining this way. But when you're doing it like this, you have the covers that are joining together in this way. So that means that you need to know not only the first and the second, you need to know the fourth one, which is 6 months in the future. So you didn't really know nothing about the script or anything else, but you need to know it because of the DC who wants to see the whole picture. It is really demanding. And Paul and I decided to go with it. It was my one of the older ideas. And the second one is to, for example, give that arc in sense of the drawings, which is the answer to your question. That was the Italian approach. Back in Serbia, when I was starting to draw the story, it was early spring, early autumn, where is a lot of moisture. And the paper is reacting to the moisture in the moment. So 300 gram paper and the moisture in the air, and my ink that I'm producing, which is really watered down, and the nib, which is damaged at the top. And when you gather all that together, you're getting having some kind of a really strange line, which is blurred and unpredictable. And then the idea was to go from that traditionally drawn first issue on paper towards the final one, which is digital. And the line is going to become cleaner, and the color palette is shifting as well as we are going to the chapters. And that arc was, I offered that to Paul in those 4 or 5 months of first when we talked. And that idea is in the book. So that is why the first chapter is as it is, drawn and colored. And it is shifting as we are going to the chapters. By the final one, the line is totally clean and there is only 3 colors almost in the chapter, while in the first one you have all of them. The rainbow. The rainbow is in the first chapter. So that is something that I came bring with me from the European approaches and ideas, basically generated here in France and in Italy. If we're talking about the villains, I'm not that much in the villains, but I already drew the Riddler, we know that. There is a Batman, a lot of it. Then I was finishing with, I finished with a Penguin, which is also one of the important ones. And in a few days in the States, this is going to be to publish the miniseries of the Joker Year One, which is going to be the main Batman series of numbers of 142, 3 and 4. And among those 3 episodes, I done covers for 2 of them. So I was already drawing the Joker as well. And that means that I'm already drawn everything that I wanted to do with the villains in the DC and also the Batman. So if I would like to choose some from DC, it would probably be Joker, for example, to do something with him. But I'm not that much into the villains at the moment.